Long before the Austin Powers movies, an Orange County resident known as Shag was wowing art lovers with his stylized 1960s drawings.
Independent producer, director Paul Gilbert brings us this profile on artist Josh Engel. I thought, oh, this is so brilliant, so Palm Springs, so mid-century modern, so early 60s, amazing, mod.
I've been drawing ever since I was a small child, and I've always been fascinated with sort of slick commercial art, the illustrations that were in advertisements or for movie posters. And I've always been interested in trying to reproduce those styles. So for a while, the bulk of my living was reproducing old illustration styles, like a sci-fi pulp paperback cover style or just a generic advertising style from the 50s or something. The paintings I make, I try to make them just sort of beautiful objects. And maybe a little bit of a story going on in a painting, but not something so obvious that you can look at it and immediately know exactly what's going on, what the relationship is between the characters in the painting.
I met Shag at the Palm Springs Tiki Oasis through my friend Otto von Stroheim. We both kind of knew about each other through the modern and tiki scene for a little while. I had seen his first painting in my friend's bar, and it was tucked away in little corners, not a very big painting. And I just thought, wow, that's really interesting. I had, you know, somebody who's doing new work based on old school style. It got me intrigued. Otto was throwing on this fabulous tiki party that I was singing at called Tiki Oasis. And there was Shag there. He was so generous and gracious. If you look at his picture of the Rat Pack from the My Way series, there's Frank, there's Sammy, there's Dean. They're hanging at the bar, and you know who it is from just a couple of little lines and the way that he captures their eyes.
When I started painting, most art that you walked into a gallery and looked at didn't tell a story. You know, artists had abandoned storytelling like back in the late 1800s, I guess. So actually telling a story or putting a narrative into a painting was really something that wasn't popular and wasn't done. But that was something I really wanted to do when I started painting. I wanted to tell these little stories. I didn't want people looking at the painting and thinking, oh, this is just a painting of a cocktail party that happened in 1958, or this is a scene that happened in 1964. I wanted people to look at it and know that A, it had never happened and could never happen, and B, it could have happened any time, 1964, 1958, 2025. And so those were kind of my initial goals in the stories I was telling.
I just love the real 60s two-dimensional, just, it's like 60s commercial art, when commercial artists were doing all the little illustrations for advertising. You like really captured that in a way that no one else really did, and it's just so stylized that I love it, and it really played into the kind of the whole music scenes I've been into.
Palm Springs sort of has certain things associated with it. Golf is obviously one of them. A swimming pool outside your walls of glass is another thing which appears in a lot of my Palm Springs paintings. And then the gondola itself, you know, the thing you can take up to the top of Mount San Gregorio. You can go from 150 degrees in the desert to snow in a matter of like 15 minutes. And those are kind of three iconic things that keep reappearing in the paintings I'm doing in Palm Springs.
I do really enjoy his sort of takes on legendary movie scenes. I know he has a piece, The Party, the Peter Sellers, The Party, yeah, which is brilliant.
When I'm starting a painting, what I do is little tiny thumbnail sketches, probably not much bigger than a playing card. And really rough as well. Like a figure might just be an oval for a head, and if it's a woman, I draw another oval for a beehive hairdo or something. Just to kind of map out where everything's gonna go. My technique is such that I do the background first, all one color. The things I paint first are the things farthest in the background, you know, the sky, the ground. And then if there's a city in the background, I paint that city. And then if there's something in front of that, I paint that. Almost like animation, like cells, you know. The thing that's closest to you is the last thing I painted. And so in that respect, you know, animation was kind of influential because old animation also influenced the look of my art, and I was thinking about how they had done that, and that was sort of the same thing I was doing in the paintings. I use acrylic paint. I can't really get the super sharp edges with oil paint, which is why I use acrylic.
People tell me what they think is happening in a painting, it's something completely different than I had intended it to be, and I'm always sort of, I always like that. It's like, there's more there than I put there, I guess, and they're sort of imposing their own ideas on it, and I like that a lot, actually.